Hey guys, and welcome to something a little bit different. The other day we went to Pendennis Castle for my brother's birthday, and I recorded loads and loads of footage of the castle, and the jousting as well. But unfortunately my camera, well my phone, actually died halfway through the day, which was a huge shame. I wasn't actually planning on uploading this to YouTube, but I got home and I started editing the footage and I was kind of archiving it and yada 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 for later reference and all that good stuff. And I thought, why not? Might as well just upload it in case anybody wants to see it. It's Pendennis Castle, which was Henry VIII's castle. It was built to actually protect Cornwall from... Quiet you. From the impending threat of the French...
And the Spanish
fleets. The interesting thing about this castle is it also has a sister castle called St Mawes. Now, that was built because Pendennis didn't have the range on its guns to completely cover the entirety of the river. So St Mawes was guarding one side and Pendennis was guarding the other. Now, the footage isn't perfect. So next time we go to a castle... we'll definitely be more prepared. Next time, I actually really would like to do a proper walkthrough of the castle. I think that would be really cool because we have so many down here. It is, after all, the land of the castles. There's so much to see. Now, the jousting, my camera actually died halfway through the jousting, unfortunately. There was two of us actually recording. Nikki was down the front with my phone. And my brother was further back with his camera. And unfortunately, like I said, mine died halfway through. But he did capture the whole lot. So I will have a link in the description to his channel, which gives a much better overview of the jousting. The jousting was really, really good. I don't think the camera really captures the impact. I did watch the footage back and it kind of seemed... not as impressive as it actually was when you were there. The massive, like, you don't quite hear the snap of the lances and the thunderous roar of the horses. It was really good. Also, there was a section that completely corrupted, which was annoying, and that is the knights actually getting into their armor. Now, what I thought was quite interesting about that was each set of armor... actually did belong to the knights. There's a group of these guys, there's 12 in England and a few all throughout Europe, and they basically do tours of the castles. Now, each suit of armor costs 12 grand. Yeah, 12 grand, because it's all custom made, has to be repaired, maintained, and that kind of thing. Now, they don't actually use full plate armor anymore because it was too expensive. And yeah. I think one of them said it's 25 grand for a full plate suit of armor, and obviously is a lot heavier. It took them about 20 minutes as well for them to actually get suited and booted, which was pretty interesting. It was a good day, and I really enjoyed it. I definitely want to go again, and like I say, next time we'll be much more prepared, and I'll actually go there thinking I'm actually going to record this for YouTube and put some effort into it. But as is, I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching.
He will need it now. First in the arena, you met him earlier on, the most important man here today, the man charged with ensuring that fair play and chivalry prevail no matter what. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Sir Paul Saddington. Now, Sir Paul and his squire Valentine will take their places at the end of the tilt round. Now, the tilt has been recently introduced at the end of the 15th century, around the year 1400, the tilt put in place to stop the knights charging bodily into each other on their horses. Obviously, we don't want to see that. And neither did they, so they put the tilt in place. So our knight marshal will take his position at one end of the tilt. And when he is ready, our knight marshal will explain the rules of the
domination of the champion of all England. This is the armoured jacks. For your delight today, we have four champions, two from all corners of the country and from our erstwhile allies in the Netherlands of Burgundy. The object of our competition will be to break the lance upon the opponent and to score points therefrom. Therefore, let me introduce to you your first champion, the Blue Knight of the North, Sir Martin Smith.
Woo! Yay!
Give a cheer, ladies and gentlemen, as he comes thundering down on his grey horse, Princessa.
Yay! Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Martin Smith, Knight Marshal at the Tournament of Nybor. Next into our arena, a golden knight, the champion of Eastern England, Sir Sean George.
Yeah. Yeah. Sir Sean, a cheer for supporting gold. Mounted on the mighty Duke.
Sir Sean George, ladies and gentlemen, one of the victorious English team at the tournament of the Vistula at Kastel Penndinas in Poland. Next into the arena, an honoured guest from the Low Countries, the court of the Duke of Burgundy, our knight in red representing the southern coast of England, Sir Walter Nicolai.
Wow! Look at him go! Fucking little way.
And finally!
Oh, jeez!
The champion of the West! The Green Knight! Late jousting at the Tower of London before the King himself! Sir Mark Griffin!
And let's see those green flags, ladies and gentlemen! As he rides in on the stately hawthorn.
Oh, there he is. What a guy.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the way that this joust will be scored.
Oh. I think my family are in.
Now, if the knight should strike the other knight upon the arm, he will score 1 point. If he should strike the other knight upon the body, he will score 2 points. If he should strike upon the shield, the écranche, he will score 3 points. And should he strike, and listen very carefully, should he strike the head, and that will be a target today, he will score 4 points.
Now,
you only score a point if the blow is powerful enough to shatter the lance. If the blow is struck but the lance does not break, it will be classed as a weak blow and a taint, scoring only 1 point. If the blow is not true, and if the lance is passed across the body, it will be classed as a barricade, no points to be scored. I apologise in a taint.
Familiarising their steeds with the tilt rail. This will enable them to run the best run and to gain the best advantage on their opponents. All rules of chivalry will apply for this lance. No knight shall strike horse. No knight shall fasten an unjust quarrel upon his fellows. And no blow shall be struck outside the tilt yard. I, the knight marshal, will see these rules good. So, ladies and gentlemen, give Sir Paul Sandington a round of applause. He has set out how it will be done. And it will be done thusly. There will be 6 rounds. Each knight shall face each knight in 2 passes. 6 rounds in all, after which we will have determined who are the 2 highest scoring knights. Those 2 highest scoring knights will then compete with their slates wiped clean in the final. 3 passes to determine the champion of the day. So, who do you want that champion to be? Is it green?
Yes!
All right, not bad. Did you expect better?
First to tilt this afternoon will be the blue champion of the North, Sir Martin Smith, against the green knight of the West, Sir Mark Griffin.
Get in there, Sir Martin.
Up the green.
Up the green.
Now that nervous moment, now the first pass of the joust. The last placed by the squire in the night.
Let's say it is!
And the cry goes up, let's say it, give him a cheer!
Oh!
Now Sir Mark. Sir Mark strikes, even though Sir Martin raises his lance. Sir Martin, noting his lance was faulty, the hollow part of the lance having left his lance, leaving only the solid part of the lance.
Oh. You
know all about it.
Squires, hear me. I will not tolerate poor lance work. This is the first and will be the last instance of such a thing.
Jeez.
Now, of course, the shoddiness of the lance will be attributed to the knights. The squires will pay dearly.
Bad squires.
And the knight marshal will see to it.
Sir Martin did chivalrously raise his lance, and therefore gave his opportunity to his opponent the opportunity to score. This was well done. For this run, I will score Sir Mark Griffin 3 points a Cornish. Sir Martin Smith of the North for his chivalry, 1 point.
Yay!
He
does not strike. Sir Martin is awarding a point for his chivalry in raising his lance and not striking with a solid part of the lance.
Yeah.
He may have been tempted.
Let's say it, hey!
Off again, give them a cheer! Yeah.
Oh. What's up, Sir Martin?
Now, once again, Sir Martin refraining from striking.
Sir Martin Smith of the North, again, raised his lance and therefore did not strike his opponent, but no point. Sir Mark Griffin of the West, a miss, and no point. Next to tilt, to be the gold champion of the East, against the red champion from Burgundy, Sir Walter Nikolai.
We'll spoil all of them, really.
Now, our knights are still conferring in the centre of the list. Now, I believe that Sir Martin was concerned that Sir Mark had struck the tilt rail and wanted to ensure the safety of the horse. The seniority and experience there in choosing not to strike the blow.
Gentlemen, clear the tilt. Champions, let's say it, Ali!
Get in there, boys! Oh! Shit!
Now, as I mentioned, ladies and gentlemen, if the lance passes across the body, that is classed as a barricade. It's an improper strike. I believe that's what's happened there. We shall wait for confirmation from the Knight Marshal.
Oh, see that! The disrespect.
Barricade, no point. Barricade for both knights, no points aside. And this is a very difficult discipline, ladies and gentlemen, and all of our knights are finding it tricky today. Cry goes up, let's say a name. The knights surge forward.
Good shot.
And Sir Walter using the flags as his breaks at the end there.
Sir Sean George, the Golden Knight of the Eastern Counties, a miss and no point. Our erstwhile guest, the Burgundian champion and the Red Knight for the South, Sir Walter Nicolai. Hey, Cronch, 3 points.
Yay! Woo!
On his beautiful horse, Flamenco. Unfortunately, a miss.
Oh, yay.
This is a very interesting joust indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Anything could happen today. Now, in an earlier pass, when Sir Martin chose to raise his lance on the second pass, it was because he'd seen that Sir Mark Griffin had struck his knee upon the end of the tilt rail and wanted to ensure that Sir Mark was all right before striking him with a blow. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, demonstrating willing to sacrifice a point in order to ensure the safety of his fellow knights. So give Sir Martin in blue a huge round of applause.
Yay! Woo!
But that is knightly indeed.
Next to tilt, ladies and gentlemen, the Green Knight of the West, Sir Mark Griffin, and the Red Knight of the South, Sir Walter Nicolai.
Yay!
Sir Walter must ride again.
Thank you.
You see the difficulty, these fiery horses, they see the tilt rail, they're off down it before the squire can arm them. They're both armed.
Let's say hello!
The cry goes up. The horses search for, give them a cheer! And I suspect a miss for Sir Mark to await the Knight Marshal's confirmation.
Indeed, Sir Mark Griffin of the West, a miss, no point. Sir Walter Nicolai of the South, a barricade, no point.
Oh.
Now, as I said earlier on, ladies and gentlemen, they do these things because they are hard.
Yay!
Great chivalry being shown by both knights there. Though they're fiercely competitive, they retain their friendship. It's a moment here to observe the skill of the squires in arming their knights. It's very much a matter of timing, observing when the other knight has taken his lance. You don't want to arm too early in case the horn surges forward.
That's it!
The cry goes up and they're off.
Oh!
And Sir Mark striking. A firm blow there.
Jeez.
Sir Mark Griffin, Green Champion of the West, strike to the accord. 3 points.
Give him a cheer, ladies and gentlemen. He's going to be very pleased with that. That puts him in a very firm position.
Sir Walter Nicolai, the Red Champion of the South. Barricade, no point.
And once again, unfortunately, a barricade for Sir Walter in red.
Yeah, go green, go West Country.
Sometimes that's how it goes.
Next to Next into the list, ladies and gentlemen, the blue champion of the Northern Counties, Sir Martin Smith. The Golden Knight of the East, Sir Sean George. So it's blue versus gold for the next round, ladies and gentlemen. Give us a cheer if you support in blue.
Yay!
And let's hear from you if you're supporting gold.
Sorry, this is too loud.
Let's say, hey! The crowd goes up and off they go. Give them a cheer. You can really hear the crunch of the chipper there. So Sean George of the East, strike to the occult, 3 points. Sir Martin Smith, the blue knight of the North, barricade, no point.
Unlucky!
Oh, the night master's ruling is thus. And Sir Martin
is he all right?
Displeasure in his own inimitable style. But Sir Sean has recovered his usual form. A smashing blow to the shield, getting him 3 points. Give him a cheer.
Yay!
No contact at this stage. Hellas is going to go for the final.
Oh, geez.
It's the most interesting joust indeed today, ladies and gentlemen. So for their second pass now, the squire's arming the knight. The knights can't even see.
I like the way you can see the people in front before we see it.
Oh. I think they felt that one in Devon, didn't they?
Oh, geez, yeah. Oh, that stinks.
Two good strikes, but what will the Night Marshal make of it? Sir Martin Smith of the North, a call, 3 points.
Yay!
Yay! Yay! Both knights striking fine blows, both receiving them very, very well indeed. That is jousting. Retain your quarters.
Yeah.
So now two of our knights must change ends because we come to the fifth round, so we ensure that every knight hosts every other knight. Two of the knights need to change ends. It's gold and blue electing to change.
Yay, come on, Iron Blue.
Who will be facing who in the fifth round?
That's our guy. The one with the owl on his head.
Ladies and gentlemen, to allow each knight to joust against his fellow, two of our champions needs must change their quarters. This is now accomplished. Next to tilt will be the golden knight, Sir Sean George for the East, and the green knight of the West, Sir Mark Griffin. So it's gold versus green. Let's hear a cheer if you're cheering for gold.
Yay!
Let's have a cheer if you're cheering for green.
Yay!
I mean, you can't do better than that. Let's hear it for gold.
Yay!
Let's hear it for green.
Yay!
Oh! And they
good
brain.
Tears
and 2 points strikes. So Mark Griffin of the West, barricade, no point.
Oh!
So Sean George of the East, strike to the accomp, 3 points.
Yay!
Mark will be disappointed by that. The Night Marshal's ruling. It's harsh, but it's final. But Sir Mark, the most chivalrous of knights in many ways, takes it in good heart.